Hey, this is Carlster95, and as promised, this is my video on how to make your own DIY glide rig. Well, I call it a glide rig, but yeah, this glide rig for your ZM crane electronic stabilizer. Now, the ZM crane is an excellent electronic stabilizer itself, by itself, but I come from Steadicam, Glidecam background, and I always like the motion of how those stabilizers work. That's what you call a glide cam. It kind of glides. So, electronic stabilizers, they're pretty good, but it kind of still lacks that stabilization as provided by a Steadicam or a glide cam. So, I tried to kind of do my own experiment with combining the electronic stabilizers with the glide cams or fly cams for that matter, and I have done some videos, successful videos of combining the two, but it's heavy because you're doing counterweight for the heavy Xeon crane, so the weights, the counterweights for the glide cam, you have to put a lot of weights to counter the electronic stabilizer. So I kind of made some experiments, and I got lucky. I'll tell you why I got lucky. But anyway, this is the result of my experiment. This is the glide rig that I concocted for my Xeon crane. So anyway, glide rig is basically like a glide cam. And you could, the Sony A6300 is off, of course, but anyway, so just like any glide, manual glide cam or steady cam, now you could do this with your electronic stabilizer, and of course the way you handle it is through that, and then you kind of, with your fingers, you basically do it like that. Compared to holding your electronic stabilizer like that, which is okay, but with this glide rig here, you have more control over the electronic stabilizer. You can avoid or eliminate the up and down motion caused by most electronic stabilizers, even the expensive ones. It produces the up down motion. And you can control that by the technique, which is the ninja walk, but this rig here does the trick and plus the technique. So anyway, let's get to it. I know you guys are wanting to find out how I did it, so here you go. There's three components that you need to get. First is an old glide cam stabilizer. I got this wieldy stabilizer a long time ago. It's basically a knockoff of the glide cam. I think it's a Wieldy 2000, but just like any manual stabilizer, I basically took the gimbal part out. This is an actual my fly cam. So I took this gimbal part out of the my old Wieldy stabilizer, and I was able to get this one and attached it to my crane. I'll show you full details on how to do it. So that's one component, an old manual stabilizer. The next component is, well, I just use a cheap monopod, and particularly the one with a rubber base, tin foil. Now I'll show you why. Oh, and don't forget the weights, counterweights. So there you have it. Those are the only components you need to get, or maybe you have some in your you got your stuff all over and you probably forgot. Now you have these components already, So, all right, here you go. Detailed procedure on how to do it. Okay, so this is your Xeon crane by itself. And as I mentioned before, you need three components to make this guide rig. First would be, well, this is the what's left of my Wilde stabilizer. I'll leave the link below for like a link in Amazon, eBay. I got it from eBay a long time ago and I'm not using it. So anyway, basically this is the gimbal for it. So I basically took out the gimbal. There's a lot of screws to take out. So what you're interested in is the gimbal. So the gimbal will have this component. This is what the gimbal on the stabilizer works. This is the important thing here. This guy. That's what makes the gimbal smoothly turn. So that goes in there. Now, the reason why I said I got lucky, because the diameter on this Wilde gimbal is basically the same exact diameter of this Xeon crane. So what you need to do, what I did was disconnect the bottom of the the mid part of the Xeon crane, and I got lucky because now this guy actually is a perfect fit for the gimbal. Now, this is not perfect because it leaves a little bit of the thread to the upper portion of the Xeon crane, but just enough thread for you to put in together or connect the two together. Oop, let me put the batteries first. Don't forget your batteries. Just like that. So that's the batteries. And make sure you got the gimbal right. Insert it right there. Just like that. Make sure a little bit of the thread is exposed. And then you connect the two. Just like that. And it's tight enough for you to connect the two. So there you have it. That's basically it. I got lucky. This guy was a perfect fit for the threads or the diameter of the Xeon crane. Now I don't know the measurement of the diameter, but all I know is I used this Wilde stabilizer. I think it's a Wilde 2000. So that's the first part. The important part is having this gimbal in there. I put a electric tape here to fatten this up so that the gimbal doesn't slide off. Now, of course, it doesn't have the monopod now, but when you hold it, basically the force is going up. So, and of course, this part here stops the gimbal. This electric tape is just to, there's a little spacing here that sometimes it's a little bit annoying around here. So I basically just put electric tape to make it snug. And then you see, there's a little bit of play here. And that electric tape kind of just puts it in place. But once you're operating the thing, don't worry, it's not going to come off because your force is basically going up the upper portion of the Xeon crane. So the next component is a cheap tripod. And this is the one that attaches to the bottom of the crane. See? It's just a ball joint tripod. And it's kind of crude. Before anything else, I did mention tin foil. Now, again, this is crude, but it does a trick. Basically, because of this gimbal here, now the whole battery is pushed towards this portion, and it leaves a little bit of gap around this joint here. So for it to have a connection, basically, I just use tin foil and stick a small amount of tin foil, make it into a little ball, So this is the tin foil I use. And basically just insert it. Now, just like that. Now you can make, you could get a more conductive piece, better one, but this works for me. I'm not really technical about it, but it's just enough for it to, for the batteries to be, to have a connection, to have contact points. Now let's test it out before I proceed. Well, I don't need to. But anyway, so that's the tin foil there. Next component is the monopod. This is a cheap monopod with a ball joint. And the reason why I chose this monopod because of this rubber piece here. Okay, so that's the rubber piece of this monopod. And basically these are just counterweights I used. And well, they're snug in there, so I'm not gonna take it out. But I basically, these are like, basically this guy here, this black counterweight, is basically old counterweights I have from another stabilizer, my flight cam. And I basically just glued everything together and I colored it black so that at least it looks good. So you could use any counterweight if you want, but I got this one from my old flight cam, like poker chips. Anyway, so that's that, and that's why I use this monopod. It's a cheap one. It's very light too, and it's very thin diameter. So, and then this is the important part, the rubber, so that I could just put it back like that. Now, again, I'm not really mechanically inclined or technically awesome. I don't know if that's a term, but anyway, it works. It's crude, but it works. So basically, that's the counterweight I need for it to counter my A6300 on the Xeon crane. So that's it. The third component, the monopod. So first component, the important component, is the gimbal from your manual stabilizer. Second component is your monopod. Third component is your counterweight. And actually, there's a fourth component, the little tin foil. And with your monopod, I like the way, because it's a ball joint monopod, so I could easily just kind of screw it in the bottom here. That's one good thing about the Xeon crane. It has this tripod adapter already. And just like that. And of course you gotta do your balancing, but for now I basically just kind of tighten like that. And there you have it. Basically, that is your glide rig. So hopefully that should explain everything. It's a little bit crude, but it works. So, just like the glide cam, the monopod serves as the counterweight for the electronic crane. And Basically, it depends on the camera weight. You could, to achieve the 3 second drop, just like this, to achieve the 3 second drop, it depends on your counterweight. I only have three of them, but at the same time, this is my main adjustment, the monopod adjustment. So that was a perfect 3 second. If you want it a little quicker, that means you're gonna make the bottom a little bit heavy, just like that. So you lengthen it, and then it's gonna be quicker. But that was a perfect 3 seconds. So it basically shortened the monopod like that, and you could achieve your 3 second drop. Now the reason why you need the 3 second drop, just like your glide cam or Steadicam, so that it can achieve that nice gliding motion with your camera. Because if the the bottom is too heavy and you do this test here, it's definitely gonna kind of wobble. Now the other thing about this monopod, especially this monopod with a ball joint, so that you can have quick, easy balancing. Now I find it easy. If you guys find any ways and means of balancing it, that's fine. But this is how I do it. So if, let's say, it's not balanced like this, just like that, it's not balanced. So the way to do it is basically loosen up this ball joint and just tighten up a little bit, and then you basically do a trial and error by kind of twisting it, bending it a little bit on the direction that you need to have that perfect balance. Up. Almost there. Oh, too much. There you have it. So that's balanced now. And once you have it balanced, you tighten the ball joint. And there you go. That's your balanced glide rig. So just like your manual Steadicam or glide cam, basically, this is it. So, okay, there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and hopefully you could make a DIY glide rig yourself for your Zeon Crane. I am not sure if this will work with any other electronic stabilizer, but especially with the gimbal that I got from my old Wildy stabilizer. But there you have it. So this is my glide rig for my Zeon Crane.